जरूर।
आपने టీవీ చూడు కావాలండి.
తిడ్డానికి కూడా దీమా బయట చల్లగా ఉన్నా
Good morning, students. Once you have to, what are the concepts you have to cover to last class? So now you have to complete it all the first 1 to 6 units, except you have the remaining one concept in the 6th unit, that is the DB scan algorithm. So once you have to see first unit completely regarding to the basics of the data mining. And what are the technologies, what type of patterns, what are the applications you have to use, and what type of attributes, data objects. These are all concepts you have to complete in the first unit. The second unit regarding to the data pre-processing. Before the data, you have to arrange it into the in a particular order. So it must be perform the pre-processing concepts. So data cleaning, data integration, reduction, data transformation, and discretization. These are the four methods you have to use in data pre-processing. So here in the data mining, for example, a particular concept you want to search, first all over the data, whatever the data you have in all over the world, the data you have to arrange it into the multi-dimensional queue. So before you have to arrange it into the multi-dimensional queues, that is the data warehouse. So you must do the data pre-processing. So in the data pre-processing, you have to use these four concepts. That is the data cleaning, integration, reduction, and transformation and data discretization. So once you have to go to data warehousing, you have to arrange the data into the data warehouse. Then now you have to mine the data from the data warehouse. So here you have to use the classification concepts and what are the association analysis and cluster analysis. Based on the data points, you have to analyze the data. So classification in the third unit, completely we have to discuss with the classification and how to solving the classification problems, decision tree inductions, decision trees, what are the methods you have to use, and selecting algorithms, decision tree, mainly you have to discuss it in the third unit. So in the fourth unit, you have to discuss with the techniques. So what are the techniques and what are the techniques you have to use? Market basket analysis, mainly you have to concentrate on this classification techniques. Bayes' theorem, Navier Bayes' classification, we have to discuss it here. That is the Bayesian belief networks. And the fifth unit, mainly you have to discuss with that association analysis. So in the association analysis, mainly it is completely based on frequent item sets. So which items are frequently purchased by the customer? So based on that, you have to, these algorithms you have to implement it. That is the appraisal algorithm, epic growth algorithms, mainly you have to discuss here. So that is the problem detection and frequent item set generation and rule generations, frequent compact representation of frequent item set, epic growth algorithm. So by using the appraisal and epic growth algorithms, how the data, which items are frequently purchased by the customer, those items you have to represent it as one group. That is a market basket analysis. You can do with these algorithms, you can frequent item sets you have to generate. That is the association analysis. And the last concept we have to discuss with the cluster analysis. In the cluster analysis, you have the number of points, data points are there. Those points you have to arrange into the one group. That is simply called it as cluster. So what are the types of clustering techniques, the different types of clusters, and which algorithms you have to use for clustering? K-means algorithm, bisecting K-means algorithms. What are the strengths and weaknesses? What are the types of the clustering types? We have to discuss agglomerative and hierarchical clustering. So these are all algorithms we have to complete in last class. So now in today's class, we have to discuss with that DBSCAN. This is the last concept in the data warehousing and data mining. So in the traditional density of the center-based approach of a DBSCAN algorithm, you have to discuss, you know, and it's the strengths and weaknesses. Okay, clear? This is the end of the concept regarding to that data warehousing and data mining. Clear? This is the DBSCAN algorithm. So DBSCAN, simply you can say that it is a density based algorithm. Density means number of points which is a specified radius. So for example, we have the data points in all over one particular area. So the data you have to store into the data points, that all data points you have to represent it as a cluster with a specified radius. That is simply called it as density. Density means number of points within the specified radius. A point is a core point. If it has a more than a specified number of points, that is the minimum points within specified radius. Specified radius. These are the points that are the interior of the cluster. So what are the data points you have? All those points within the radius only. So these points, these data points we have to represent it as core points. What is the border points? That means a border pointer is fewer than the minimum points within the specified radius, but is it in the neighborhood of the core point. So ekkadaithe border place low, you have the one points are there, some few data points are there. Those type of points are called border points. What are the noisy points? Noise points is a point that is not a core point or a border point. And is a border not really not outside the border or inside the border? That is simply can represent it as if it is any point with a not in the core point or border point. That type of points are called noise points. So that is regarding to that DBSCAN algorithm. This is the density based algorithm. So with the specified radius, what are the points are there? The number of points, that is simply called as density. And particularly 1 kilometer of around 10 kilometers radius, what are the data points are there? Around 100 kilometers, what are the data centers are there? So that is the specified radius. You have the data centers. That is, you have to number of how many data centers are there. That is simply you can say that density. That is the number of points within the specified radius. That is simply you can represent it as DBSCAN. So this DBSCAN algorithm you have to use for that density. See here core and border and noise points. How it shows. This is the core points, and this is the border point. Here you have to see, this is the core points you have to represent it. within the cluster, we have to represent it this core point, and border point we have to represent it as within the cluster, but it is a border we have to represent it. This is the we have to represent it. These are the points we have to represent it as border points. And noise points outside the border we have to represent it as noise points. This is simply you can represent it as core, border, and noise points. So what are the algorithm for the dbSCAN algorithm we have to use? dbSCAN algorithm mainly we have to use it for that to eliminate the noise points. We eliminate the noise points. So it performs the clustering on the remaining points. Current cluster label will be assigned to one first. Then for loop, all core points do. If the core points has a no cluster label, then current cluster label will be assigned to current cluster label plus one. Label the current core point with the cluster label and the current cluster label. So this is the end if. So if a condition is true, then the two statements will be executed. So otherwise, you can perform the all core points. So once you have the completed the core points, then you will go. We'll go for all points in the EBS neighborhood, like border points. So all the points in the EBS neighborhood, except the point itself, do. If the point does not have the cluster label, then label the point with the cluster label, current cluster label. So you can perform the all operations up to condition is true. Otherwise, you to perform the all the border points we have to come. So this is the end of the for loop and end of the core points and the end of the border points. So remaining noise points we have to eliminate. This is the way we can eliminate the noise points. And then only you can perform core points and border points. This is the diagram. This is the algorithm we have to represent the dbSCAN algorithm. So dbSCAN algorithm we have to represent how core, border, and noise points we have to represent it. These are the original points. So EPS is 10 and minimum points is 4. We have to represent. So here, green points we have to represent it as 4 points. Red points we have to represent the noisy points, and which are the blue we have, that is the border points. Only border values only we have to consider. Remaining noise points we have to eliminate. That is the dbSCAN algorithm. When the dbSCAN works well, so the original resistant to noise can handle the cluster of different types and shapes. So this is the original points. The clusters we have to represent it like this. If the dbSCAN does not work well, this is the original points. So we have the three or four colors of that. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this could be applying the dbSCAN algorithm, but it does not work well. So automatically it will represent like this data points. One color data points, so this is another color. This is the another color data points. So whenever the specified radius, we have to decrease it or increase automatically, that we have to represent it as, we have to change the its data points. Minimum points for this, the specified radius 9.75, we have to consider. We can represent it like this. If the minimum 0.4 and radius you have to represent it as 9.92, so that automatically the value should have to change it like this. That is regarding to that when the DB scan does not work well. So determining the radius and the minimum points. So if the idea is now for the points is in a cluster, their kth nearest neighbors are at roughly the same distance. Noise points have the kth nearest neighbor at the farther distance. So plot sorted with distance to every point to its kth nearest neighbor. So here you have to represent at 0 to 3000. Okay, that is the determining the EPS and minimum points. Cluster validity. So cluster validity, we have to represent the for supervised classification. We have the variety of measure to evaluate the how good our model is, accuracy and precision, recall. And cluster validity is also represented in cluster analysis. The analogous questions how to evaluate the goodness of the resulting clusters. But the clusters are the eye of the beholder. How to how to evaluate them. So here cluster validity, we have to evaluate it to avoid the finding the patterns in noise, to comparing the cluster algorithms, to compare the two sets of clusters, to compare the two clusters, sets of clusters as well as two clusters. You have to compare sets of clusters as well as clusters. This is the way we have to evaluate the cluster value. Clusters are found in a random data. You can apply it here. This is the random points. The red you have to represent it as random points. Whenever you have to apply the k-means algorithm, so you can address the entire data you have to, data points you have to arrange, convert it into three clusters. Red points was defined as one cluster, and green you have to represent it as another cluster, and blue is represented as another cluster. That is the k-means algorithm. Whenever you have to apply, you can get like this. Whereas in the random data, you have to apply it for the DB scan. So the data points you can get like this. This is the blue points you have to represent it as one cluster. And the dot, red dots are there, that is the noisy points. And the green points you have to represent it as one cluster. And black points you have to, squares you have to represent it as one cluster. So here we have the three dots are there, red dots, that is you have noisy points you have. This is the way you have to clusters you have to found in random data using the DB scan algorithm. So whenever you have to apply the complete link to the clusters found in random data, how clusters are found in random data using the complete link algorithm. So these are the green points we have represented in one cluster, reds and blue. These are the clusters found in random data for using various algorithms. What are the different aspects of the cluster validation? So here we have to determine in the cluster dependency of the data set, distinguish whether non-random structure actually exists in the data. Comparing the results of the cluster analysis is to externally known results to externally give class labels, and evaluating the how well the results of the cluster analysis fit the data without reference to external information. Use only the data, comparing the results of two different sets of the cluster analysis to determine which is better. Determining the correct numbers of clusters. That is the different aspects of cluster validation. For 2, 3, 4, those are the steps you have to further distinguish whether you want to evaluate the entire clustering or just individual clusters. Next one is measures of cluster validity. Numerical measures that are applied to judge various aspects of cluster validity are classified into following three types. One is the external index, internal index, relative index. So these are the three types of numerical measures you have to use for the cluster validity. First one is the cluster external index. It is used to measure the extent to which cluster labels match externally supplied for the class labels. So entropy you have to represent it for the external index. Second one is the internal index. It is used to measure the goodness of the clustering structure without respect to the external information. Some of the squared error, that is the SSE, we have to represent it for the example for this internal index. And the last one is the relative index. It is used to compare the two different clusterings or clusters. So often we have the external and internal index used for this function, SSE or entropy. You can use any one this for this relative index. These are the measures of the cluster validity. Sometimes these are the referred to as a criteria instead of indices. Sometimes a criterion is the general strategy, and the index is the numerical measure that implements the criteria. That is regarding to that measures of the cluster validity. Next one is measuring cluster validity via correlation. So correlation you have to apply for that cluster validity, but how you can measure? So here you can use the two types of matrices. Measuring the cluster validity via correlation. So here we have the two matrices, proximity matrix or index matrix. So these matrices we have to represent it as one column and one row, and for each data point, the entry is one is associated pair of points belongs to the same cluster, or different clusters we have to represent it as zero. That is the proximity matrix or incidence matrix. When we have to compute the correlation between the two matrices, since the matrices are symmetric, only the correlation between the n into n minus 1 by 2 entries needed to be calculated. High correlation indicates that points belong to the same cluster or closer to each other. Not good measure for the same sum density or contiguity based clusters. Measuring the cluster validity via correlation, the data points you have to represent it like this. The correlation of indices and proximity matrices of k-means clusterings of the following two data sets. So see here, this is the correlation. for minus 0.9235 for this correlation, you have the minus 0.5810. Next one is the using the similarity matrix for the cluster validation. That is the order similarity matrix with respect to the cluster labels and inspect the visual. So this is the three clusters, but in the k-means algorithm you have to apply. But whereas here you can get these points like this, blue, green, and red. Using the similarity matrix for the cluster validation, a cluster clusters in random data is not too crisp. You have to represent it like this. That is the DBSCAN algorithm. Using the cluster similarity matrix for the cluster validation, clusters in random data are not too crisp. That is the k-means you have to apply. Completely how you can apply. This is the DBSCAN. So this is regarding to this one DBSCAN algorithm. How you can apply? What are the internal measures? Mainly you have to represent it as the internal measures. The clusters in more complicated figures are not well separated. Internal index is used to measure the goodness of the clustering structure without respect to the external information, like SSE. SSE is a good comparing to the two clustering or two clusters average of SSE. Can also be used to estimate the number of clusters. So SSE is current for the more complicated data set and represented like this. Framework of the cluster validity. It is need to the framework to interpret the any measure. Example, our measure of the evaluation is value is 10, that is good, fair, or poor. Statistics provided a framework for the cluster validity. The more typical clustering result is more likely to present valid structure in the data. You can compare the values of the index that result from the random data or clustering to those of a clustering result. If the value of the index is unlikely, then the cluster results are valid. So generally here you have to compare the results of two different sets of the cluster analysis. The framework is less necessary. So statistical framework for the SSE. See the diagram it shows comparing the SSE of the 0.05 against the three clusters in random data. So if you hear like this, histogram you have to represent 500 sets related to the random data points. 100 is distributed over the range of 0.2 to 0.8. So this is the statistical framework for the correlation. These are the internal measures for the DBSCAN, that is cohesion and separation. Cluster cohesion measures how closely related to the objects are in a cluster. That is simply SSE. That is simply can call it as cluster cohesion. Separation means squared error. The measure how distinct of well separated a cluster is to other clusters. So cohesion and separation. This is a cohesion WSS you have to call it as. Separation you have to represent it as BSS. Summation of I to X belongs to C of I. X minus MI whole square. Separation you can call it as summation of delta of C of I within the bracket, that is M minus M1, M of I, by whole square. Internal measures, cohesion and separation. Example, SSE, BSSE constant. You have to find out the value with the cluster 1. You can find out the value, the total is 10. But K2 is the cluster you have to consider as. Similarly, you can get the 10. So this is the cohesion and separation of proximity graph. So now the coefficients, external measures of the cluster validity and entropy and purity. And we have to represent the values. This is the cluster validity. This is the strongest effect of the direction. Cluster analysis, the remaining blackout of the accessible only to the those two believers who have experience and great courage. This is the last word. This is regarding to the DBSCAN algorithm along with the deterrence and disadvantages. So this is the end of the sixth unit. Next class onwards, we will discuss take one unit and we have to revise. Thank you.